Used correctly, barbells are the most powerful muscle-building tool in the gym because they let you use heavy weight, hitting the biggest muscles in the body, legs, back, and chest, going to failure, increasing gains. So in this video, we'll take you through 18 recommended barbell exercises for your workout program to help you build a complete muscular physique, hitting all the major body parts, top to toe. Starting with the biggest muscles in the body, quads. And our first big compound exercise for adding size to your legs, squats. Keep the core engaged, back straight, chest up, bringing the hips down below the knees, exploding up. If you're a newbie, start off with the rack-supported version. More experienced lifters can build up to heavy weights, adding impressive mass to the lower body. Next, an exercise that hits the whole of the back of the body, from hamstrings and glutes to upper and lower back. Deadlift. Starting with the bar on the floor, and with a slight bend in the knees, bringing the hips forward, squeezing the glutes. At the same time, pulling the shoulder blades together, chest up. The genius of the deadlift is that it gets a range of muscles across the whole of the back of the body working together in coordination. As with the squat, it's possible to build up to heavy weights on this exercise, as long as you follow correct form. Building muscle, adding more weight each workout. But it's also possible to focus more on different parts of the deadlift movement, using variations to target hamstrings, stiff leg deadlift. This version typically starts from a standing position, keeping the legs slightly bent, lowering the weight to the point where the hamstrings feel it most before coming up again, hitting hamstrings as well as glutes. To focus more on the glutes, an exercise called Good Mornings. With a slight bend in the knees, barbell across the shoulders, bringing the hips back, then thrusting forward, squeezing the glutes as you come forward. And this exercise can be tricky, so it's not about heavy weights. Protecting the lower back by keeping the spine straight and not taking the head lower than the waist. Another variation works more on the upper part of the deadlift, hitting a range of muscles in the back. Rack pulls. The support eliminates the lower part of the movement, bringing the chest up, shoulders back, squeezing the shoulder blades together at the top. And these three variations are good if you're new to deadlifting, or if you want to target different parts of the deadlift. But over time, advanced deadlifters can build up to heavy weights, adding more weight each workout with progressive overload, making deadlift one of the most effective exercises for building muscle. Squats and deadlifts are most effective at the start of your workout, but many trainers come back to barbells later on leg day for lunges, keeping the knees in line with the toes, chest up. This exercise isn't about heavy weights. Lunges work the smaller, stabilizing muscles in the lower body. Having the weight up on the shoulders also engages more of the core. Now on to chest. The pec muscles, another large muscle where barbells can really add size, using heavy weights for big compound movements. The key exercise here is bench press, using the bar to build up to heavy loads. With a grip slightly wider than the shoulders, concentrate on shortening the pec muscle by bringing the elbows together. The flat version works all the pec fibers evenly. Moving to an incline bench puts more emphasis on the upper chest, adding to that look of fullness in the chest. Working on a decline bench makes the lower chest do more work, helping develop that line which gives definition to the lower part of the chest. Again, these are all big compound movements suited to heavy weights. Great for exhausting the muscle at the start of your workout. Before you move on to more targeted exercises using cables and dumbbells. So now, arms. Biceps and triceps are trained with isolation rather than compound movements. But barbells still play an important part adding mass to the arms. Barbell curl is the standard exercise for biceps. Elbows tucked in, keeping the body upright, exploding up, slowly down. Hands placed roughly shoulder width apart to target both heads of the biceps equally. Going for a wider grip will hit more of the short head on the inside of the bicep, while a narrow grip works more on the long head, down the outside of the arm. An easy bar gives a more natural wrist position and uses more of the forearms as well as a muscle called brachialis, which lies under the bicep. On all these exercises, it's important to keep the elbows locked in position. One way of ensuring this is to go for preacher curl, isolating the bicep and preventing the body from swinging. And for a well-balanced arm, time to hit triceps. Recommended bar exercise for triceps is skull crushers, keeping the elbows high and locked in position. Bring the weight slowly up to straighten the arm, locking the elbows by squeezing the triceps at the top. Another great exercise for adding mass to the triceps with progressively heavier weights. Like the arms, the shoulders are made up of a group of relatively small muscles: front, middle, and rear delt. So shoulders need to be trained from different angles, reflecting their different movements. This military press is one of the most popular to include in the mix, especially as a starter for your shoulder workout, firing up the whole shoulder as well as the stabilizing muscles around them, keeping the weight moving as you press up, not locking the arms, slowly down. At this point, your shoulder workout will continue with more targeted exercises for front, rear, and middle delts. But many trainers come back to barbells at the end of their shoulder session for shrugs. Shrugs work the traps, the muscles which sit above the shoulders. They can be trained using heavy weights with less risk of injury. And using the bar stops you rolling your shoulders, making sure the traps are directly targeted to complete the overall look of the upper body. Finally, back. The back is a complex system of interconnected muscles, so a full back session will include a range of different movements and angles. Pulling movements for width. Rowing movements for thickness. Bent over barbell row is a staple exercise for back day. Knees bent, back straight. Lifting the bar by drawing the elbows up and back. Using a bar can help you progress to heavier weights, adding thickness to that middle back. But if you're worried about maintaining stability or protecting the lower back, there's also incline row on a bench, bringing the elbows up to complete that squeeze in the middle back. So those are just some of the many exercises where barbells offer a range of benefits. But it's also important to keep shocking the muscle by bringing dumbbells and machines into your workout, using different grips, patterns of movement, and targeting specific muscles with isolation.